like I told these boys in the meeting, we don't need anything over the top today. We got a good race car, we got a good driver, we got a good pit crew. All we got to do is just everybody carry their weight, and we'll be just fine at the end of this thing.
Well, before I could walk, I had a wrench in my hand. I was my mama's little angel, my daddy's second chance. He went end over end. The first year he went pro, and he lost part of his eyesight, so he couldn't race no more. He never lost his touch when he got under a hood. He knew how to make them run. He knew one day he would see his name in victory lane and engraved on that cup, just like all them other crazy fools racing in their blood. He'd put me on his lap when he'd drive and I'd take the wheel, and he'd say, what do you think about that, son? How does she feel? You just wait till them little legs get long enough to reach the gas. Once you put her on the floor one time, there ain't no turning back. Every Saturday, he'd take me out to the garage. He'd take an empty bucket, fill it full of engine parts. He'd sit me down and pour them out in front of me on the floor. I'd have to tell him what each one was and what each one was for. We'd jump in his old car and go down to the race that night. He'd tell me what each driver was doing wrong, what each one did right. He could always pick the winner before they ever took a curve. Number three might have the car, but 43's got the nerve. But before I turned 18, Daddy said, now pretty soon you'll be old enough to race, but I'm gonna leave it up to you. Taught you all about it, taught you everything I know. You gotta have a car to do it, and you gotta work and buy your own. Nobody kept them any longer than they kept a pair of shoes. They started showing up at every used car lot in town. A V8 on a go-kart, easy terms, no money down. Me and Daddy and my uncle took her home and we tore her down. Checked her out real good, cleaned her up and bored her out. Took out all the seats, pulled the carpet off the floor, knocked out all the glass, and we welded up the doors. Well, the first time that I raced, my qualifying was a shame. I started out way in the back and came back about the same. Pulled her in the pit, couldn't look my daddy in the eye. He said, if you quit now, son, it's gonna haunt you all your life. See, it ain't about the money or even being number one. You gotta know when it's all over, you did the best you could have done. And knowing that it's in you and you never let it out is worse than blowing any engine or any wreck you'll ever have. Since then I wrecked a bunch of cars.